In this video, we are going to discuss about compensators. Actually, the definition of compensator is a device inserted into the system for the purpose of satisfying the specifications. We know the performance specifications. The main performance specifications of a systems are accuracy, relative stability, speed of response. So these three are the basic performance specifications. So we can have three more performance specifications. So if a system is time domain, transient state, so their performance specifications are rise time, maximum peak overshoot, then settling time, or we can say damping ratio. Then if the system is in frequency domain, the transient state performance specifications are phase margin, gain margin, resonant peak or bandwidth. Root locus technique is employed in designing system when the time domain specifications are given. For a system, if the time domain specifications are given, we can use the root locus concept. The given specifications are in terms of frequency domain, so we can use Bode plots, Nyquist plots, Nicholas chart for analyzing or designing the system. So in among these methods, Bode plot is the simple and also best method for analysis purpose. Gain is to be designed to meet the desired specifications. So we know the specifications. So specification in the sense for time domain, so these three are the specifications. For frequency domain, these three are the specifications. So to meet the given or desired specifications, so we have to design the gain. So increasing the gain may result in the power stability or instability. To meet the desired specification, either frequency or time domain, so we have to design a gain. So when we design a gain, if the gain is increases, so it may leads to poor stability or instability. In such cases, introduce additional devices or additional components to alter the behavior or to meet the desired specifications. For example, so if we want to design a system for 40 degree phase margin, so for that we have to adjust the gain to meet the 40 degree phase margin of the particular system. Suppose if we increase the gain, it will lead the system to become instability or it may show poor stability. In order to bring into stability region, so we have to add one more device. That device or component, that device or component is called as compensator. It may be series or parallel. So this is the open loop system. So suppose if the component or device is added in series with the system, it is called as series compensation. Suppose if the system is, so this is the open loop system gain. So now a component, its gain is parallel with G2 of S. So this part is nothing but the shunt compensation, or we can say a parallel compensation. So this is nothing but the actual open loop system. So it is shunt compensation. Actually, the choice between series and shunt compensation depends upon the nature of signal in the system, power levels at various points, components available, designer's experience, economic considerations, and so on. So depends upon these five, or among these five, or we can say based on these five categories, we can select either series or parallel compensator to bring the system into stable region. So basically compensators are, so there are four, we can have four classifications. One is electrical compensator, mechanical compensator, hydraulic compensator, and finally we can say fourth one is pneumatic compensator. So among this, electronic network or electric network or electronic device serves as compensator in many applications. For example, there are three types: lag compensator, lead compensator, or lag lead compensator. So lag lead or lag lead in the sense, so phase angle. So we are going to add a phase angle along with the available system. Available phase angle means that is lead. If it is subtract means that is lag. So if both we do, that is called as lag lead compensation. So to bring the system unstable to stable region, we can use the compensation technique to get the desired performance. For example, if the particular system is now running with unstable, so by using compensation technique, So we can convert into stable, and also we can get the desired specification also. Suppose if the system is stable already, but if we want to get the desired performance, for that purpose also we can add the compensator. So the purpose of compensators are simply from the stable system to get the desired performance, or else the purpose of compensator is to convert unstable system to stable system and also to get the desired performance. So these are all the basics of compensation and types of compensations and types of compensators.